So this will be the final video that I make for this guy, at least as far as the breakdown part. I already pointed this out, so you can see that cam gear, it definitely wobbled out, and you can see even there it caught the case a little bit. There's some scarring right there, and it wobbled that hole out there. It's unfortunate. Apparently S&S had developed and sold a product that was gear driven instead of chain driven, which is how the Evo and the Sportster was gear driven. You had to line up all the different gears for the cam. So Harley-Davidson thought this was an improved setup for this chain driven mechanism, and I guess this dog here or paw or whatever, and it is, it's got a good, groove in it, but must have wore out enough that it caused enough of a tolerance issue to allow the chain to wobble back and forth on the gears for that. I mean, gears, hardened gears to me, kind of like what they do on their oil pump, seemed like a lot better idea than a chain-driven gear with a plastic cog to cheapen up the line. I mean, thanks, Harley, and then blow up the motor. That shame on me for not doing enough research. I think I probably, since I've owned this bike, maybe put 6,000 miles on it. Maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less, but before me, my father has always changed the oil and serviced it very well, and I've always changed the oil and serviced it very well. The unfortunate part is, I didn't get onto those forums until after it was too late, and you can see, there's some horizontal grooves in here, which I'm assuming are from parts of metal getting stuck up in the rings, the oil rings and compression rings and stuff like that. And got our heads there. The heads look good. The pistons don't look terrible, but you can see where all the debris caught it, and on both the front and the rear. And so there's definitely metal down in there now. So and even if you look like up in here, you can see it's in the oil passages. So I could tear this apart. I'm sure I could rinse it out real well, turn the bearings, and get all the dirt out of it, and maybe buy a half of the case instead of a whole case. S&S seems like they have an aftermarket case that's pretty decent. I'll probably just clean up the bearings and everything. Look at the bearings, make sure there's no pitting. I probably don't even have 20 miles on it after that bearing started making its way loose or starting to fart around. But definitely will take note in the future that if you have a bike that stalls out, it most likely is due to something other than just the fuel. So especially when your vehicle's fuel injected. And what would happen is I would start it up, and after about a couple minutes of running, it might die out. And then I'd go down the road and it seemed like it ran right, and then it would just kind of stop somewhere, and I'd hit the starter button, I'd start right back up, and I just thought it was overloading or loading up in the fuel, and that was not the case. So very disappointing. We'll see if we fix it and figure it out, or if I'm gonna go out and buy a BMW in the interim. I think I'm gonna look for a nice used BMW, and at least be able to ride, because I don't know that this is gonna get fixed anytime real soon.